A robots.txt file is a text file that contains the rules and regulations for search engine crawlers such as Googlebots, Bingbots, and Yandexbots to interact with your website. If a robots.txt file exists on a website, just go to their domain and add a /robots.txt, and you will see the content of the file. Typically, a robots.txt file is to prevent search engines from crawling certain parts of your website, especially duplicated content that usually occurs in e-commerce sites. But generally, if you don't need to restrict any parts of your website from the search engines, you shouldn't worry too much about it. But if you're interested in learning the uses of the text file, grab some coffee and let's get into it. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the WordPress SEO plugin that gives your business the best chance of beating your competitors on search engines. We have been actively publishing practical business and SEO guides to help you grow your business. So if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. And if you have been watching our videos but you haven't yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Now, every website should have a robots.txt file, especially when you're trying to rank your content on search engines. Even Google said it themselves that you should have one. If your site doesn't have one, in theory, search engines will not crawl your site, but most search engines still do in practice. So, what do you need a robots.txt file for? First, especially for e-commerce sites where you allow visitors to do a product search or filter products through categories or attributes, every search, filter, category, or attribute will create multiple pages on your website and it may blow up the crawl budget, which means search engines may neglect crawling important pages on your website because they are busy crawling pages that are not that important, such as those pages I've mentioned. A good example is this IKEA. You know, they are one of the largest furniture stores in the world, and there are tons of products on their website. So if you go to their website and visit the robots.txt file, you will find that they are disallowing search engines to crawl their filters and sorting pages. There are so many of them. Don't worry, you will understand the robots.txt language in a while. What are these asterisks, slashes, and everything? Second, you can prevent search engines from crawling certain files on your website. For example, images, PDFs, etc. in case those files are meant for lead magnets. For example, where you want to capture people's contact information before giving out that document. You definitely do not want people to be able to search for that document on search engines. Third, you can keep certain parts of your website private by disallowing search crawlers from crawling either a file path or URL parameters. I'll show you some examples in a while. Number four, you can specify a crawl delay to prevent your servers from being overloaded when crawlers load multiple content of your website at once. And finally, it is a good practice to specify the location of sitemaps on the robots.txt file so they can find it easily. Now that we know what we can do with the robots.txt file, let's understand the language of the search engine crawlers. The language, in technical terms, it is called the robots.txt syntax. The first thing you gotta know is the user agent. This syntax is used to call out specific search engines crawlers. When a search engine crawler finds your website, the first thing they will do is to look for your robots.txt file in the root folder of your website. They will scan the text file to see if they are being called out. If they are, they will further read the parts that are related to them. The names of the user agents or search engine crawlers can be found in this list, which I will put a link to in the description. Next, we got a disallow rule that tells the user agent not to crawl certain parts of the website. You can only add one disallow command per line. So that's why you see the IKEA robots.txt having so many disallow rules. The allow rule only applies for one of Google's crawlers called Googlebot to allow it to access a page or subfolder even though its parent page or subfolder may be disallowed. For example, in RankMath's robot.txt file, we disallow all search engines from crawling the folder called wp-admin, which is the file that resides on the root folder. But we want to allow search engines to crawl this particular file within the parent folder we have disallowed. The crawl delay tells the crawler to wait at your site's doorstep for a couple of seconds before loading and crawling pages of your site. An example will look like this. Next, there is the sitemap that is used to tell search engine crawlers where your XML sitemap is located. And then we have the forward slash, which is the file path separator. If you leave it as an individual property, it will mean the entire folder of your website. Next, we have the star, which is a wildcard that represents any sequence of characters. In other words, everything related to a certain criteria that comes after. For example, in the IKEA robots.txt file, it is disallowing search engines to crawl everything with the URL parameter that contains the filter and everything that comes after the filter. If you leave the asterisk as a standalone character, it would mean everything. For example, you are calling out all the user agents. Next, everything that comes after the hashtag will be marked as comments, just like what we have on our robots.txt file. And finally, the dollar sign signifies matching all the strings of characters that comes after it. For example, the site is disallowing the solutions URL parameter and every URL slug that comes after. A robots.txt file should be added to the website's top level directory. As I've said, when a search engine crawler found your website, the first thing they will look for is the robots.txt file in the root folder of your website. On the file manager of your web host, the robots.txt file should be under your home and within this public underscore HTML folder, as you can see over here. And if you have subdomains, for example this, it should have a folder with your site name like this. Click into it, and that's where you should add your robots.txt file. In my case, it resides here. Now, if you use RankMath, you don't actually need a robots.txt file on your root folder, because you can manage the contents of your robots.txt right here, under General Settings and Edit robots.txt. It says here that the contents are locked because a robots.txt file is present in the root folder. So to manage the robots.txt here in RankMath, let's go to the sites directory and delete the robots.txt file. In case you have existing commands you want to copy over to RankMath, you might want to visit the file and copy the contents to be added to RankMath. Once you have deleted the robots.txt from your root folder, refresh the page, and you can now edit the robots.txt file accordingly. By default, if you do not have a conflicting robot.txt file, RankMath will add these commands for you. It is basically saying, we are calling all user agents. Please do not access our folder called wp-admin, but we allow you to access just this document in the folder, and this is the sitemap index. If you don't have any special restrictions for search engines, the default robots.txt from RankMath should suffice. But if you do, then stay tuned. Now, a robots.txt file can have more than one group, and each group can consist of different rules. Each group has to begin with a user agent, followed by the rules for that crawler when they are visiting your website. Every rule needs to be written in a separate line. You should not write all rules on one line, nor should you break up one directive into several lines. Instead, it should be like this. By default, we can assume that a user agent can crawl any page on your website unless you specifically ask them not to do so by adding a disallow rule followed by the file path or URL parameters. In general, everything is allowed. That's the reason web crawlers exist. It only makes sense, right? If you want to call on more crawlers, you will add the user agent followed by the rules. And then finally, the sitemap. That's the structure of robots.txt. Now that we understand the robots.txt language, let's now go through some use cases. As I've mentioned earlier, if you own an e-commerce store, those filter or internal search pages are great for your customers, but it confuses the search engines because of duplicate content and it wastes crawl budget. So to prevent search engines from accessing those pages, we have to look at the site's patterns. For example, let's check out IKEA's website. On this page, we can add some filters. Let's say we want this size, and then maybe the color we want black. And on another product category, we can add filters as well. This will help us discover the products we are looking for easily. And on the URL for both pages, you will see this question mark filters equal. The same goes for the other page. So this pattern appears on all pages that allow users to filter products. To prevent search engines from crawling these pages, all we need to do is to add the user agent. You want to call out all search engine crawlers, so you add the star. Following that, on the next line, you want to add disallow everything that has this filter URL parameter, as well as everything that comes after. It is that simple. Now, depending on the purpose of your website, you may want to prevent search engines from crawling your internal search pages. For example, on this site, you can see a search function here. Let's search for something, say, sitemap, and here's the article related to the search. If you check the URL of the search page, take note of the pattern. Let's do another search. This time around, let's search for web host, and you will see the URL like this. Can you see the pattern? It is this question mark as equal. So to prevent search engines from crawling these internal search pages, we will add the disallow, everything which has this pattern, and everything that comes after. It is rather similar to the previous example. But not all websites have the same pattern for the internal search pages. Take for example IKEA again. If you search for, say, mattress, they will have this URL. If you do another search, say sofa, you will see this link. Now the obvious pattern is this question mark Q and equal. So you can add this URL parameter into the disallow rule. But if you take a look at IKEA's robots.txt, you will notice that they did not disallow the question mark Q equals. Instead, they disallow everything that has the search parameter instead. Which makes sense as well because on the URL of the search page, they have this. Which means everything that comes after that has this search parameter will be disallowed. So it really depends on the pattern that makes the most sense for your business. As you have seen from IKEA's example, they disallow the search, which is a site structure. So if you don't want search engine crawlers to access certain parts of your website based on a site structure, you can just add this to the disallow rule. For example, if you do not want search engines to access the feed pages of your website, just add disallow everything that has the feed URL parameter. Simple as that. Now, if you do not want certain file types to be crawled, as I've mentioned earlier, that some file types are meant for lead magnets, here's what you need to do on your robots.txt file. Every image, video, audio, PDFs, or files you add to your WordPress website will have a unique URL like this PDF file or this image. Did you notice at the end of the URL comes with the file extension? And this is a pattern across all other file types. So if you want to prevent search engines from crawling all PDFs, all you need to do on your robots.txt is to call on all user agents, and you want to disallow everything that ends with a .pdf. Similarly, for some reason you want to disallow JPEGs, it will be this. And this is for PNG. This is for Excel files. And so on. Pretty straightforward, right? To block all web crawlers except for one, you can first call out all user agents and add a rule to disallow them from accessing all the files and pages on your website. But you will call out another specific crawler, such as Googlebot, and you say there is nothing to disallow, so you leave it blank. If you want to allow more user agents, just call them out like you did with the Googlebot. The best way to discover if there are any errors on your robots.txt is through the robots testing tool by Google. We have left the link to this page in the description. First, you want to select the property. Make sure that you are logged into the right Google profile that manages the search console of your website, and you will see the robots.txt file of your website. If the information found here is different from your existing robots.txt, as you can see, the information from the testing tool is missing this, disallow all PDF file on the website, what you want to do is to copy all the information and paste it on the tester and hit submit. Then on point number 3, you want to ask Google to update their information by clicking on submit. Once done, refresh the page and you should see the changes. If you have made a mistake, for example, you are missing a colon, you will see a warning message at the line you have made a mistake. So this is a great way to debug if there are any errors on the syntax of your robots.txt. Now in this case, I want to block all search engines from accessing my PDF files. I want to see if it works. So I'll copy one of the PDF's URL from the website, and right at the bottom, I'll paste the link here, leaving only the URL slug. And when I hit test, it shows me that this rule blocks the URL, so it works. Whenever you add a rule, test all variables to be sure that all the intended blockages are blocked without any unintended blockages. I hope I've made this tutorial easy for you to understand and follow. It can seem intimidating at first, but it becomes rather easy if you take some time to understand it. All you need is just to understand the language search engines are speaking. If you find this video helpful, do us a favor and smash that thumbs up button. And do subscribe to our channel for more SEO and business knowledge. We have quite a number of useful videos already and it is constantly growing. So make sure that you hit the bell notification as well to get notified when new videos are published. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.